he's organized and he's on the ball. Never miss a day at school. And he's the underdog. What they am I talking about? Everybody know what the song's about. They be trying to hide the history, but they know who we are. Do you want to see everybody rise to this degree? Raise your hands high if you agree. Just say yes, sir.
Good afternoon, Nick Wilson, Brandpreneur. We'll be here with you in just a minute. You're watching Brandpreneur, Brandpreneur Live. We'll be with you in just 1 minute. Please stand by. Good afternoon, Brandpreneur Live. Nick Nelson, Brandpreneur, coming to you. How you doing? How's everything going? Today on Brandpreneur Live, we have some special guests. These ladies are doing. These ladies are doing something that's incredible, and I want you to meet them. We have Dr. Nicole LaBeach and Crystal Khalil. Here in Brandpreneur Studios with us. Good afternoon, Diana. How are you doing? Israel, I appreciate you for joining. We're just going to give a few more people a little bit to come on. But while they do, they have an organization called International Slumber Party. And one of the things that we're going to be talking about today really is the whole concept of loving and leading Black girls. The more I come in contact with individuals, especially a lot of my sisters right now, many of them come to me with a heart for working with young girls. And but there's a difference between wanting to do it and actually taking action. And these two ladies that we're going to present to you here in a few minutes, they've actually taken action in terms of creating not just something small. If you're going to go big, and you know I love going big, right? If you're going to go big, I say you go as big as you can and impact as many people as you can. So before we get into it, definitely want to recognize some people. Jessica, I see you. Medina, I see you. Medina Jett is a Brandpreneur also. Arlene, I see you. Jessica, I see you. All right, so we're looking good. We're looking good right now. If you would please help me recognize the remarkable Dr. LaBeach and Crystal Khalil. What's up, ladies? How you doing? Good to see you. Good to see you. Uh-oh. Talk to me. I can't hear you right now. Uh-oh, something's going on with your mic. I can't hear you. You there? Okay, I can't hear y'all. Let me ask you something. Just going out to, can you, everybody's saying they can't hear you right now. Just give us a second while we get their technical stuff together. Uh-huh. That's what happens when y'all fancy with these Bluetooths and everything.
Don't talk about it.
Yeah, there we go. There we go. I hear you now. I hear you now. I hear you now. I hear you now. Y'all so fancy. Y'all so fancy with your technology, right? Uh-huh. Y'all like besties sharing. One person got one Bluetooth, the other one got the other.
You know how
but that's fine. Indeed. That's how we do it. We make
that's
it work.
Right.
We make it work.
Because
we make it work.
It makes it better. For sure.
Well, hey, I appreciate y'all. I appreciate y'all coming on and really helping and talking with both our Facebook and our LinkedIn community. So everybody on Facebook, hello. Everybody on LinkedIn, hello. Ladies, oh my God, and they're saying hello at the same time and waving people the same way. Y'all been around each other way too long now. Listen. Way too long. I just need you to know that y'all starting to act alike.
Nick, they call us the Wonder Twins. Now we know that might be dating us. If you know the Justice League,
I'm right there with you. I might look like I'm in my 30s, but Mama, let's be clear.
Right. So when we do this, you know what it's going down. I get it.
So Dr. Nicole, why don't you introduce us to you, and then Crystal, you introduce us to you.
So, hi everybody. So glad to be a part of your audience and to see everyone. Say hello to everyone. My name is Dr. Nicola Beach, and I am part of the Sister Diamonds. I've been in the profession of change management and leading leaders through executive coaching, through...
Uh-oh. We lost you.
Sorry about that. We got a little interrupted. Sorry about that. Through the change management work that I've done and really just holding the space for people to lead their lives and not be asleep behind the driver's seat of their lives and their business for almost 20 years now. So just glad to be here and tell you guys a little bit more about what we're up to.
Cool. A couple of people out there saying hello to you.
Hi, everybody.
Demetri is saying hello. Hey. You got a couple of your Sister Diamonds out here.
Yeah.
They're saying hello as well. Come on in the room. Come on in the room. There we go.
Come on in the room.
All right, Crystal, why don't you talk to us about who is you?
Hey, everybody. I'm Crystal Khalil. I am one of the Sister Diamonds and the Wonder Twin.
Yes.
I have spent my entire career, just a little over 30 years, on the procurement side. I recently left Porsche as an executive, the head of procurement for North America, and decided to earn my wings in executive coaching. I partnered up with Dr. Nicole, and I'm really excited for the journey that we have embarked on together.
Yeah.
All right. Well, it's funny because I knew Dr. Nicole first. So I had an opportunity to spend some time with Dr. Nicole. That was 2018. That was 2018, Doc, when we first looked up, right? Right.
So let me add another thing to that. Do you remember? Oh my God, we were on my porch and making of the brand that has now blown up for you. It your idea originated on the porch. Do you remember
all this stuff originated right there on that porch? You was like my test, right?
Go ahead, Nick. You can say
you muse. My test.
You can say inspiration. It's okay.
Dr. Nicole was my, for all you brandpreneurs out there, Dr. Nicole was my inspiration in 2018. I was on her porch, right? Didn't know what the brand I was doing, but that was fine. I knew we had something going on, right? But then in 2019, when I did know I was doing, that's when I got with Crystal.
Right.
But yes. I didn't even know y'all knew each other. Look at Crystal. I see you. See what I'm saying? She was doing it, right?
Yes.
But now y'all come together, form of, shape of, and we have the slumber party. Now, when you both came to me, y'all said, Nick, I just need you to be on this call, right? And I didn't know what this was all about. And I was like, okay, I said, it's both of y'all. Y'all my people. I'm going to be on the call. But when y'all started talking about it, I was just amazed. And it's not like y'all trying to figure it out. Y'all figured it out. Not only have you figured it out, but you have people that are engaged and have already contributed. And this all deals with the concept of, our Black girls and helping our Black girls. And so what I want to talk about here real quick in terms of loving and leading them, what was the the inspiration behind this. First of all, how did y'all two link up and even talk about this and even get started about it? So what is it, first of all, and then how did y'all make that happen?
It's so funny because we met in business.
Yep.
I was still at Porsche at the time, and I was introduced to Dr. Nicole by one of my colleagues for some potential business. And so we went out to lunch, and we were suited and booted, and we were all professional and ready to have that business conversation. And 3 hours or 4 hours later,
y'all were girlfriends.
Closed the restaurant down. Closed it down. They started sweeping and doing stuff around us because they didn't want to be rude. And by then, Nick, we were crying and like, what is going on here?
We just
like,
bonded.
Yeah.
It was seriously like, it turned a business conversation turned into a heart conversation.
Yeah.
And we bonded. I don't even know how it happened. And then we lost touch because she was bidding on some business. You know, we kept it professional. We lost touch.
Right.
6 months later,
yeah,
we connected again for brunch and it happened again. We were at brunch till it turned into lunch.
Oh my God. and you know, it's bad. It's really bad when you are exhausted because of the emotional connection, but you don't want to leave.
Yeah.
You're like, can I have some more water?
Can you
give me another Coke? Because you're like, I don't want to miss anything that this conversation is supposed to bring to my life. And that's just how it's been.
That's just how it's been. And then when I left Porsche, she didn't know that I had left.
Nope.
And she found out and reached out to me and said, can I just celebrate you? Can I invite you to my house for breakfast? And I just want to
hold on. She said what? She said, she said, can I just celebrate you?
That sounds like that. That's powerful.
Mm-hmm.
And I came over for breakfast, and 8 hours later, International Slumber Party was born.
Right.
Hold on. Crystal, you said you had breakfast?
Yeah.
She served you. Hold on. When I was there, you know what she served me?
What?
Popsicles and cheese.
But that's fine. You missed out, Nick.
That's not
time. That's fine.
This is fine. Can cook.
Right. That was before the Brandpreneur.
That was before.
But let's, ladies, let me
just acknowledge some people out here in the audience. First of all, Michael Dyson, great to see you. Michael says hello. Arlene Henderson says hello.
Hello,
Monique Cleveland says awesome. There goes Monique Cleveland with her head tilted to the side. Awesome.
Yes,
right.
Yes.
Right. And then one of your LinkedIn users says, hey, Sister Diamond. So people out here. They loving on you. So
you
celebrated y'all. Y'all started y'all, and y'all came up with this. What did y'all figure out? What problem are y'all solving? What problem did y'all figure needed to be solved?
You know, when we first started, we thought that this was going to be something for women our age. And what we figured out was with everything that was happening with COVID, with just being on the pulse of what our younger sisters were going through, many of them were moving back home because they were leaving school. Many of them were losing jobs because they're young and the newest on the job. Many of them were leaving graduate school because of COVID. And we started really recognizing, you know, the ones who really need to be poured into, re-energized, and just loved on are younger sisters. And when we started talking to them, we just threw it out there and said, what do you think? And they were like, this is amazing. Mm-hmm. We love it. We love the idea. And one of the things that they said to us was, you know, a lot of people are really not concerned about what happens to young Black women. And they pit us against each other all the time. They make it seem like the only thing we're good for is competing against each other, but our collectivism doesn't matter. And we said, well, wait a minute, because we're evidence that collectivism works.
Yeah.
You know, when I called Crystal and she came over for breakfast, I made her breakfast.
It was
from scratch.
Yummy.
Everything I did was to say, sister, you've made an amazing leap leaving your corporate executive job. I'm out here as an entrepreneur that's been doing it for over 18 years. I got you.
Yeah.
Whatever you want to do, if I can help you, I got you. And I wanted to celebrate her. And I remember her saying, what should I bring? I said, just some flowers, because you deserve some flowers. So what we did with the young ladies that we talked about is we said, you know what? If we can model this for you and pour into you and help you to look at each other and see the dynamism that you have in the women in your life that are your age and older, then we've done something. We've come against that narrative that is just competition. You can't trust her. You can't depend on her. You can't rely on her, because what we know as sisters is this is the way we've made it to this point.
Yeah.
It's been other women and other men like yourself that have said, what you need? I got you.
Yeah.
So the International Slumber Party is really a love letter to women of color, 18 to 25.
Our former selves.
Yeah. Yeah,
because what we've recognized is, you know, if I had this when I was 18 and 25, my career would have accelerated so much faster. Yeah. If I had this between the ages of 18 and 25, there's no telling how bad I would be right now. You know, just the mentorship, the sponsorship, the love, just being the sisterhood. And so we wanted to provide that experience for young women so that they could understand. This is the magic in Black Girl Magic. This year, I had a vision that this is the season of illumination. And Dr. Nicole says this is the season of collectivism. Yeah. So illumination and collectivism, shining your light and working together to be bright. It's a lot of darkness in the world right now. And we have an opportunity to shine our collective lights to provide hope and help people to see a better future and give them the things that we wish we would have had at their age. And what we did, it was, we Dr. Nicole's an educator, I'm an educator. We partnered with some students and said, we don't want to create an experience for you. We want to create an experience with you. We want to empower you to create the ultimate experience, and we're going to fund it.
Yeah. And they were like, what? For real?
Right. And so we put our heads together, we put our finances together, and we started supporting them. And then we realized, this is a big job. This is taking over. This is a lot of work. Yeah. And so we said, who can we call to get more help? And we started picking up the phone, and we started calling other diamonds, other professional women, other professional men like yourself, Nick, and saying, we have a big vision. We've got a big idea. We've got some extraordinary young women creating this experience, and we need some help.
Right.
And right now, we're at almost 150 diamonds working on this project to make this experience happen on August the 1st.
Okay, so a couple of things. First of all, I got to get in the comments for a second. Marshan said, this is such a vital conversation, 100%. I absolutely believe in this greatness, generation's greatness. Monique says, this is beautiful. Arlene says, I'm so excited for the young ladies' lights that will be turned on, never to be blown out. And Diana says, Crystal and Dr. LaBeach, our young women need this so much. They want guidance and they are asking for help. And then my brother, Eric, because, you know, it's all about the brothers here also. He said, awesome idea. And then my brother, Michael Dyson, a redemptive and healing idea. God bless you both. So what I want to, because I'm all about being, as I sometimes say, Pacific, going deep, not specific, but Pacific, right? Specifically, what is this? What are you doing? It starts on August the 1st.
Yeah.
I need people to understand the bigness because it, y'all could have did something small, but y'all said, you know what, we're going big. So help explain the bigness of the International Slumber Party.
So you said Pacific.
Pacific.
We said, we ain't scared. Come on. We said, we ain't scared. So what the International Slumber Party is an international opportunity to develop girls in their leadership, pour into them, give them a platform to have a great time and connect with each other in a virtual party that is literally going to run for 24 hours so that our young women in South Africa, our young women in Ghana, our young women in London, Canada, New York, all over the world will be able to connect together in a space where experts, influencers, DJs, because our girls love to have a good time, everybody will come together to be all about them. They're going to bring their best conversation. They're going to bring their transparency. People like you, Nick, are going to show them how to cultivate their brand. You know, people like Angela Dean are going to talk to them about fashion and how they look in that brand. We've got executives from corporate America coming into the conversation. We've got a social justice panel, diversity and inclusion panel. All of the things that the young women, are saying, we want to know about this. We want to know about this from the best of the best. And we want opportunities to not only connect with one another, but to connect with our elders. You know, there's a perception out there that not only do we compete all the time and we don't have respect for one another and respect for ourselves, but we don't respect our elders. And we're here to tell you, our young women are saying, we want to hear from them. We want to ask the questions that we don't get to ask. And we want to have an intimate connection where we can sit. We even have a panel called At Your Feet, where we can sit at their feet and say, talk to us about wealth. Talk to us about relationship. Talk to us about how to keep ourselves safe, but be dynamic and move in direction where people see us and see our value. So it's this 24-hour cycle of content, training, workshops, conversations. Man, Crystal and I are so excited. And let me just say this. You know, we understand the power of mentoring. My oldest mentor has been in my life for 25 years. I can't count nor pay for what I've learned from her, what she's learned from me. 25 years from me just going up to her and saying, I just want to be like you. I just want to hang out with you. I can't be as tall as you because I'm only 5'3", but I just want to be you. And she said, well, you're not a stalker. So come on, baby. Just go where I go. I don't think I do anything that's special. But 25 years later, so what Crystal and I talked about was, how do we create an opportunity to give them what they've been asking for and not feel ego to think we're the only ones that can do it?
Right.
So come one, come all. There is a young woman, 18 to 25, that can learn from you, because I don't have just one mentor. Mm-hmm. I have many.
Absolutely. And you know what, Nick? You and your audience, think back to when you first started out in corporate America in your job.
Yeah.
Think back to that experience. When I think back on that experience, you know, I was a first generation college student, first one in my family to go to college. And I had been taught to be a hard worker, wrote a book about it. Work hard, right? You got to work twice as hard to get half of what your competition is going to be giving, right? And I remember walking into my first corporate job and I was so excited and full of anticipation, but what I didn't expect to feel was alone. I looked around and I felt so alone. Yeah. There was nobody in there that looked like me.
That looked like you.
There was nobody in leadership that looked like me.
Straight up.
There was nobody that said, come here, baby. Let me show you how this works.
Right.
Let me show you how to navigate this environment. And I didn't know. And I couldn't call home because my folks didn't have those types of jobs.
Right.
They didn't know how to tell me how to navigate corporate America. And what we want to provide for our young ladies, our sister diamonds, is that sisterhood connection, that sponsorship. One of the things that we told our volunteers, our diamond mentors in this program, is the most important responsibility that you have is to open up your network to these young women.
Absolutely.
It's to sponsor them in their growth, because every new level requires a sponsor.
Absolutely.
So you're helping them to put this party on. You're helping them. You're sharing your expertise. You're mentoring them. But your most important job is to open up and sponsor them. If somebody's in your LinkedIn network that they need a connection with, then you connect them. If there's an internship opportunity at your office, then you provide it. Help them. We're helping them fix up their LinkedIn. We provided a resource for that. We provided a resource to help with their resumes.
And recommendations.
Absolutely. Write a recommendation letter for them if they need it. So we are providing what we wish we had.
Yeah.
And like I said, if we stop and think for a moment what that experience was like for us, because many of us are probably first generation college students. And believe it or not, a lot of these young women coming out of college today are still first generation college grads.
And let me go one step even back. You know, our girls, we see, listen, we have this debate. We know they are women, right? We know they are young women. But I'm gonna tell you, we have such a heart space. We always say our girls, because that's girls, how we feel about them.
Yes.
But just going a step back and confirming what Crystal is talking about, you know, our young women are 18 to 25 years old. Mm-hmm. When I was that age, I was at Spelman College. I entered Spelman at 17 and turned 18 at Spelman. My first internship, now let me just plug my alma mater. We all know it's hard to get in there. Because the best of the best are trying to be in this sisterhood and be in this number. Here I am, a college student, and I go to my first internship. And Nick, I look good. I'm dressed.
I know you did.
You know, I'm ready. I'm like, I'm so ready. I got that confidence. I show up an hour early. And when I finally meet my mentor, he says to me, "You're not what I expected." Hmm. Right? And he looks me dead in the face. He says, "You're not what I expected." He then does not give me any assignments the entire summer. I am creating my assignments because I am not what he expected. And what Crystal and I recognize is this imposter syndrome of being all that and then some, but being told that we're not, starts for many of us at pivotal points in our careers that are going to drive purpose forward. So what we said was, you know what? We're not their solution. We want to be a part of their solution.
Yeah, one of the things I realized in corporate is when I started opening doors, it was my responsibility to hold them open.
Yes.
For those coming behind me.
Right.
And that's what we're doing. We're holding the door open and saying, "Come on, girl.
Come on.
We got you. We've got you. We're your sister diamonds."
Right. And let's tell them what that means.
Oh, so sister diamonds, right? What does it mean? Nick, what is the only thing that can cut a diamond?
The only thing that can cut a diamond? Now, y'all know I flunk science. Will y'all please tell me?
We got you, though.
We got you. Look, a diamond is the hardest substance, right? And it is formed under immense pressure and immense heat, just like a high-performing woman. Just like a leader, right? We are formed as people of color, especially. Immense heat, immense pressure is what forms a diamond. And the only thing that can cut a diamond is another diamond.
He got it. He like that crazy.
Hold on. If I turn to our Bible when we talk about it as men, right? Men sharpen men as iron sharpens. So same sort of deal.
Yes.
I get it.
So what we realized was all of these young women are diamonds. They just need somebody else to come on in, take an interest, give them access to information. Some of them want to buy their first house. Okay, baby, if you want to buy your first house at 19, we are not here to stop you. We are here to help you. We are here to give you information. If you're 18 years old and you say, "I want to start my own business," you're not too young. Let's help you do that. If you say, "I want to have a social media influence because I've got some ideas about things and I just started my first real job." Oh, we got Nick Nelson. He can help you with your brand. Mm-hmm. We wanted to bring all of our super friends to the conversation, and we've got room for more.
We got room. We definitely have room for more.
Here's the deal, because they already asking. They're like, how can I support? Now, realistically, y'all have a GoFundMe, right?
Yes.
And I'm gonna put the banner here at the bottom in terms of what it is. Now it's a long thing, but it's so long. But I'm gonna do it.
You know, for you today, we're gonna connect with Bit.ly so we can make it not long, because we don't want you talking about us.
That thing's right. So long. Right. You hear me? Who gonna remember that, Doc? No, you know what they're gonna do?
Or just go to GoFundMe and put in International Slumber Party, or find us on social media. Cause trust,
they're gonna follow you. Follow media. Crystal and Nicole. Follow yes, Crystal and yes. Nicole. Yes. They're both on LinkedIn. They're yes. both on Facebook. They have yes. plenty of information on their social media channels. So yes. take a second, follow them both. All right, it's actually I believe it's Dr. Nicola Beach on LinkedIn and Nicola yes. Beach on Facebook, and it's Crystal Khalil everywhere. So
absolutely.
So with this, what are some of the things that you're needing? How can people help? Before we answer that, let's get into some of the comments.
Okay.
Yes. The only thing that can cut a diamond is another diamond.
Yes.
Right. Can't imagine where I would be now if I had been armed with this information when I was in my 20s. Thanks to the Wonder Twins for creating this space for young women. Yes. This is going to be life and game changing experience. Go, ladies. And then Mr. Kendrick is like, will y'all please tell me how I can sponsor?
Oh, thank you, Mr. Kendrick. Right. Thank you so much.
Crystal, can y'all please tell me how I can sponsor? Yes. Right. Right.
Yes.
I would love to help you with first generation college students. So again, if you want to sponsor, if you want to help, GoFundMe International Slumber Party is the name of the organization, or we'll make it easy. Just follow Crystal Khalil and Nicole LaBeach on either LinkedIn and Facebook. But how specifically can people help?
So one of the things you talked about was GoFundMe. So Crystal and I have invested our own money for this conversation to begin. And what we want more than anything is for this to be our party.
Yeah.
You know, the people that are working with us as mentors, they have given so much of their time and so much of their business equity towards this conversation that if you can give money, we appreciate it. Why? It's sad to us that there are girls in places like St. Vincent, places like Guyana, places like Brooklyn that can't afford $20 to go to a party, but their potential is so incredible. We're like, we gotta find a way that if they want to be there, we can give them access to being there. And sponsorship, personal sponsorship helps that.
The other personal sponsorship, number one. What's number two?
Corporate sponsorship.
Yes.
Listen, we're both, you know, corporate folks. I used to work for Rupert Murdoch's companies on the East and West Coast as a leader. We know that life, okay? Crystal used to work for Porsche
and
as
Coca-Cola.
A leader and Coca-Cola. Mm-hmm. Coca-Cola is one of my clients. What we want is corporate sponsors to come in and say, what do you need?
All right, hold on. Crystal, check this out.
What?
Tamala, you hear that?
Yes!
Tamala, dear. Tamala, they need corporate sponsorship.
We need
How are you doing, Tamala? Yes. So good to see you. So good to see you.
I'm so happy to see you. Thank you for joining us, Tamala.
Because you're in responsible hands, and we are leveraging this conversation for your future leaders.
Yeah.
You know, this is what this looks like, is your future leaders will come from this experience. The other way is, you know, if you are a small business, because a lot of the things that Crystal and I are doing, we are intentionally doing with small, diverse businesses. If you are a small, diverse business and you're like, you know what? It's a slumber party. We have an amazing pajama line we would love for your girls to wear during the party. Connect with us and let's see if we can make that work. And let's see if we can move that traffic to your website to elevate what you're doing as a small business. Because Crystal and I understand business and we understand small business and big business, we're like, yeah, you know what? There are enough resources to go around. Yeah. We just need to connect with you, understand where you are as far as how you create your opportunities and products. And if it's a fit, we'll do our best to make it happen.
And we understand exposure. So we really appreciate you, Nick, for giving us your platform, sharing this platform with us. But if you can share this, you know, we appreciate your donations, your support, but also share, get the word out, because we want young women all over the world to have this experience. We want to bring them together and allow them to connect. And all the topics Dr. Nicole mentioned, those aren't our topics. That's what these young women have told us they want to hear. They want to learn about. So we want to have this experience. And then we're going to be looking for mentors. Yes. So definitely stay connected with us, because we will be doing some connections and we would love to have you guys join us as mentors for these beautiful young women.
And let me add two other things to that. Your nieces, your sisters,
your interns,
your young employees, your mentees that you already have, make sure that they're in the party.
Get them a ticket.
Not only do we want you to participate, if you have an expertise that fits what we're doing this year, this is our first year, but you know, it starts at home. Mm-hmm. Who do you know that's between the ages of 18 to 25 that you plan on calling in the next 24 hours or texting and saying,
love it,
what are you doing on August 1st?
Absolutely.
Save the date. I will get your ticket. Or save the date, you get your ticket. Whatever it means to help us get them in the room, get them in the room. And the other thing that we talk about, you know, the brilliance of being 18 to 25 and being able to vote. We are starting an opportunity where we're like, you know, we recognize 10,000 girls is our audience. 10,000 voting girls that can say, I'm willing to commit to 10 of my friends and me being an ambassador for them registering and them voting. And then those 10 girls saying, and I commit to 10 of my friends registering and voting. We gotta be the solution we've been looking for.
The change we wanna see.
Right,
and
right.
And you have a message to all of your listeners and your viewers. If you have a message that our young ladies need to see, connect with us.
Yeah.
If they need to hear from you. And I'm going to tell you, this is not an ordinary live. We have invested in some pretty cool technology because we want to make sure that this.
Pretty cool. First of all, Crystal, that is about the most understated thing you said the whole show. So let me tell you what this really is. Pretty cool.
Yeah.
This is like virtual, like 2D technology sort of deal where they're like in virtual environments. So, you know, this is not like the Zoom call that you have at work. Okay.
Let's just be clear.
This is not
the ISP mansion.
Yes.
The ISP mansion.
This is the ISP mansion.
Yes.
Right.
Because,
you know, let me tell you something. Now, had this, and I don't mean no harm. Had this been some brothers, it might be a Zoom call, right? It might be a Zoom call. But but my sisters, boy, y'all be stepping it up. Now it's the ISP mansion.
It's 2D
in virtual environments.
Yes. Listen, Nick, don't talk bad about us, but we're looking at chandeliers right now for them to mock up. Listen, because the young women were like, when we enter into
this conversation, I can't with y'all.
We want a chandelier.
Yes.
And it needs to be blinged out. So we went back to the folks and said, chandelier.
May happen.
The foyer of the slumber party, when you enter, when the doors open, they want a big chandelier. And they were like, okay, can you send us pictures? We'd be like, stand by for pictures.
Right. It's all about the experience. And we want them to feel the love. Because everything is coming from love.
I get right? it. Hey, my sister Carol in London town, she says, I'm in London, UK. I'm on a mission to help women find their sparkle so yes. they can have a greater impact in the world. I love to get involved in
yes,
mentoring.
Yes, Carol, we would love to have you.
Please, have. Please. Yes. I'm a small, diverse business, and I'd love to connect with you.
Absolutely. Love it.
Right, right, right. Brothers would have definitely done a Zoom.
I can do that. It's all right. We understand. It's okay. That's funny.
Yes.
Hey, I can tune, bro. I'm just calling out what it is, man. I'm just calling. But it would have been powerful. Oh boy,
right.
It would have been powerful. But it would have been a Zoom. We would not have had chandeliers. We would not have had.
Indeed.
So any last words in terms of how people can help, what they can do. Again, GoFundMe, the International Slumber Party, and then also, please, on both LinkedIn, Facebook, International Slumber Party on Instagram also as well, but Crystal Khalil and Nicola Beach, and then GoFundMe, International Slumber Party. Any parting comments, any last words? Y'all done already sold it. Right. But, you know, that's what you do. That's what you do. Right. Right. Y'all bad. Hold on. They're one of mine. So they're bad.
Right?
They're one of mine.
It's clear.
They bad to the bone.
Yeah.
I promise you they bad. But what are some last words in terms of just what people can do, how they can help. And this is your final pitch. If we were in a court of law. This is your final thing that you before the judge, right? Your closing argument. Yeah, please, yeah. Your closing argument.
I would say share some more, pray, and then share some more. Yeah. Why pray? We believe all 10,000 of those young women have already been chosen.
Yes.
We don't know who they are because we've got to walk through time to get to them on the first. But they've already been chosen. Mm-hmm. So for those of you out there who pray, because Crystal and I do,
mm-hmm.
we ask that you pray that all obstacles will be removed. Mm-hmm. Any imposter syndrome that comes up and says, man, you can't go to that party. You won't fit in. You're not even in college. This probably for college girls. Mm-hmm. Anything that would come in the way of their light being cultivated, mm-hmm. because when you cultivate, it makes a difference. Share some more, pray, and share some more. If you do that, we're going to be good.
Mm-hmm. And remember, this is the season of illumination and collectivism. We need you. We need your help. We need your help to get this out there, to get the exposure, to reach these young women. We need your help. So join us.
Yeah.
We appreciate you.
Come on in the room. The doors of the church are open.
Yes.
Won't you come? It's your time.
It's your hour.
Hold on. And Tamala came through with that corporate sponsorship.
Yeah,
we need waste management trash cans to dispose all of the waste during the
event.
That's funny.
All right. Follow International Slumber Party on Facebook and IG as well. So, ladies, I appreciate you for your time.
You know,
y'all get the job done, right? Y'all get the job done. And I'm just happy to know you. We gonna make this thing happen. Chandeliers and all, and I just if we're doing 2D, I need my brandpreneur room. I need the brand room.
We got you.
But I don't need no chandeliers. All I need is a nice comfy couch. Right. I don't take up a whole lot of space. That's fine.
We got you.
All right, ladies. I appreciate you.
Thank
y'all
you,
give me a hand real one time. Give me some claps. Give me some thumbs up. The lovely Crystal Khalil and Nicola Beach. I'm gonna treat it like a sexy chocolate. They're so lovely, don't you agree?
Yes.
Right.
We'll take it.
Bye, ladies. I'm gonna see y'all later. Bye. All right. Before I let everybody go, we launched our Facebook group. So I'd love it if you participate with us. What's the difference between the Facebook group and our LinkedIn community? With our Facebook group, we're doing more of a training and we're cultivating. I needed a place where all of the people that I've worked with can just kind of come together, learn and grow. And that has been one of the most requested things. Nick, you know, I'd love to get together with some of the other people, some of the other folks that you've worked with. And facebook.com/groups/brandpreneur. Get noticed, personal branding mastery. So this is the collective place where I'm inviting everybody that I've worked with from various walks and lanes of life to come together. We will learn and grow. I'll be doing some teaching there, but this is where we take it down and we break it down into a smaller micro community. So definitely I would appreciate it if you would go out there. You can see my post today. It has the direct link so you can participate, but it's going to be a great thing. We're going to learn a lot and we're going to leverage that platform to come together as a micro community and all promote each other and all get noticed. So definitely I look forward to engaging with you there. Man, it's been a lot. I've enjoyed y'all today. International Slumber Party, man, this is so very needed. And Crystal Khalil and Nicola Beach, as you can tell, they are very passionate about what they do. They have very giving spirits and they are just awesome, awesome human beings. And I'm just happy to know them. So as always, you can find me brandpreneur.com. I'd love to work with you. We start our new brand line. Our new brand line starts July the 7th. It's about to be an amazing experience. We're working with a little under 20 people right now for our June cohort. So our July cohort starts July 7th. And we also have a cohort that we'll be working with in August. So brand line is a thing. It's a part of what we're doing now. So definitely give it some consideration. And that's it. So from me to you, Brandpreneur out. I appreciate it.
Never miss a day at school. Ha. And he's an underdog. What am I talking about? Everybody know what the song's about. They be trying to hide the history, but they know who we are. Do you want to see everybody rise to this degree? Raise your hands high if you agree. Just say yes, sir.